Going off of that, what you just said, for someone who is starting a new campaign or they are building an organization, how would you start a digital program? What is like day one, this is what you need to do? Or just like you said, if they're nervous about trying something digital, how would you encourage them to really build out their digital program?
I would like Jewell's input on this one first.
Jewell, what should we do?
Oh, man. Well, if I were starting out a brand new campaign and I was thinking about, this is me stalling if you can't tell. I think for me, again, like I go back to the three things, is what I'm doing raising money, is what I'm doing spreading my message, is what I'm doing organizing. But like the problem with that is if you're brand new, you've never run a campaign, like you don't even necessarily like know what that means or like, you know, how to do that or what that should look like or like what the like tactical breakdowns are that like go along with that. So I don't know. I think that's a really hard question. But I think for me, like, I would think about those three things, like how can I make sure that it fits into those buckets? How can I make sure that I'm meeting people online? How can I make sure that people know who I am, what I stand for, why they should care, and why they should vote for me? How I can get people to like care enough to donate $3, $4, or $5 to my campaign? Like, I would think about those things, but frankly, it's really hard to break down into like a I've never run a campaign sort of thing. I've never, frankly, launched a campaign. Well, I guess that's actually not entirely true. Well, you know, sorry. But like, well, I guess I'll talk a little bit about Made to Save. So I worked at an organization called Made to Save. Our whole thing was like getting shots in arms and communities of color. Like, we know at the start when folks were starting to get shots, like it was mainly like black and brown folks who were not getting vaccinated. So we started this whole campaign, basically. It was a bunch of campaign people. We like came together and just, we funded, like we've sent like $7 million to organizations that were like actually doing work similar to that, like across the country. And like empowered them to then reach their communities. So we did some work there. We had to launch a campaign. I guess like our biggest things were like trying to get our message out. We frankly weren't raising money because we had already raised a lot of money from folks who like just gave us money, plus the government gave us money. Anyway, I feel like I'm rambling, but my point is like they were just like some of the things I would consider, but as you can see, I don't actually know the answer. I don't know if there's like a silver bullet like answer to that.
But with Arena, everything starts with goals, folks. You have to have very clear lines of what success looks like, and even if it's in the context of launching an effort or a campaign, what does success look like? Is it reaching X audiences? Is it trying to raise X amount of dollars? What's going to come clear through that process is what are the actual strategies that are going to help me get me there, right? And that starts at the audience level, because sometimes it depends on the objective. I could think of a few, maybe even more than that, use cases where maybe digital is not even the use case that I'm going to be applying to a specific goal. But it all starts with what you're actually trying to achieve, and it's going to become pretty clear on how you apply digital into those spaces, and then it rolls into all the stuff that we're talking through today. Social media, how that plays a role into that process, text, email, relational, all these pieces kind of funnel together. But maybe the take from the campaign manager is a good one too.
Well, it's again, like, I don't know how to answer the question, because I just think it's digital, that's your campaign. It's like, if you want to launch a campaign, like, okay, you know, this is the strategy on Facebook, on Twitter, right? And this is how like our Twitter strategy communicates with reporters and the chattering class, whereas Facebook, and you know, is an older voter, right? And then there's TikTok, which is a younger voter. So I don't know. I just think it's hard to answer that question, just because digital has just become everything, right? Like when we launched, you know, whether it was Val or even like Andy Kim for Congress, I mean, everything from the what you're saying, what's the first thing you're saying, right? Like on that launch day, you have to think about it like, okay, what from what you're saying is going to be a headline on digital news outlets, right? I don't even think you can think about it without, you know, again, what we currently call digital today, right? Like from every aspect. So it's just part of the launch checklist, right? The light box on the website, right? Is like, I mean, that is a key to raising millions of dollars on a Senate race. I don't know if I'm answering the question correctly, but
no, I think you all summed it up.
Nothing I'll say though. Sorry, is that like, especially now, like it used to be, you know, you had to hire the finance director first. And I come from finance, like no shade on finance directors, but now I think it's like you got to hire whoever's doing your digital, right? What we call the digital director, right? Like, you know, we did that in our campaign with Ryan Thompson, our deputy campaign manager, who was the chief technology officer at the DCCC. We chose him to launch this with us because we knew we needed the digital apparatus to work, right? From the texting to the social, you name it.
I would say conversations, because what you're doing is engaging people in conversation and creating dialogue. I think another way in the context of fundraising is cultivation, which I think is what you're speaking to, which is, by the way, a very good thing and is something you should continue to sell to anybody that you're working with or candidates or causes to, because to your point, you can't just ask people for things over and over again because they want input and they want value and all the other pieces that go into why they're doing the work. But in terms of, and there's also things that can be softly measured, right? But again, it just needs to tie back to the overall goal. So I would say conversations is what I would allude to, at least from an organizing mindset, but you can define that how you like, and I think it still ties to success.
Kind of piggybacking off of Jose is really kind of a lot of, more of a nonprofit terminology, but digital is everything, and we kind of have to treat campaigns like a business and a nonprofit and a campaign. And so moving folks up that ladder of engagement, understanding that like you have a funnel and it's gonna get smaller and smaller and smaller, and your goal is to convert people from the top of the funnel to the bottom of the funnel, and just be realistic, right? You're gonna lose people. You're gonna have people at the top that just sign a petition or sign up for your email list. That's all you're ever going to get for them. The important part is understand that and move on, because you want to cultivate your list, cultivate your community, and drive them towards action. So know your community, know where they are, and be okay with people staying at different stages of your ladder of engagement or your funnel.